Hi, I'm Sam Carman with the Indiana Division of Forestry, and we're out in the woods today to talk about competition in the woods. And with me is District Forester Janet Eger. Janet, how do trees compete?
Trees compete for sunlight and space, nutrients, and most of our woodlands, particularly in southern Indiana, have way too many trees trying to grow in too small of an area. And so sometimes we have to thin down the forest so that the trees can grow at their optimum.
Okay. And in looking at this stand, you selected this tree in particular. What are we going to do here?
Well, one of the reasons why we selected this tree, Sam, is because it's competing with a tree that the landowner wants. And we always have to look and see what the landowner wants out of their woods. And this particular landowner really likes wildlife. And so we're looking at trees that are going to provide a lot of benefits for wildlife through fruit production or perhaps mast and den trees. And not only the wildlife, but the landowner is also interested in growing some good timber for future harvesting. Mm-hmm. And those things work very well in hand. This particular tree is competing with a persimmon tree behind us, which has wonderful wildlife values. There's also some young oaks in this area, so we want to eliminate this tree from the competition.
All right, well, how are you going to do that?
The easiest way to do this, Sam, is with a chainsaw.
Cut it down.
The problem with cutting trees down, Sam, is that you have a safety issue there.
Sure.
And we want to stay as safe as possible in the woods. And so instead of cutting the tree down, we're actually going to cut a ring, actually two rings, around this tree, and that will cut off the flow of water and nutrients to the tree. In the meantime, this tree then is dead. It's going to be providing good wildlife habitat for other species. And so we get a double benefit, and we're also safe in the woods. All right, Sam, I want to point out a couple things that are really important when making these girdles. The first thing is that it has to be deep enough so the cut goes into the live wood. And you can see the white area there, that's the live wood.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And the other thing, it has to be a complete girdle to where it actually makes a circle. Sometimes when you're on a hillside, like right here, it's difficult to make a perfectly level circle, and that doesn't matter as long as the ring is continuous. And that's what happened here.
So is that it? Is he done?
He can be. On sassafras, they will die just by using the chainsaw girdle. However, like I mentioned earlier, we can really ensure a kill by using chemical. And he will just go ahead and put the chemical all the way around the bottom ring, and that will take care of it. The chemical does not have to run out. It just needs to saturate the ring. And Sam, that's essentially it. We have now deadened this tree. It has released the trees that we want from any competition, and our other trees will grow fine.
For more forestry information, be sure and visit our website. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the woods.